the mega freight train is on the move. The 4,500 horsepower locomotive is thundering through the wilds of Canadian Labrador, pulling a payload of iron ore worth nearly $2.5 million.
Bring a little piggy to market.
But the train is approaching Ross Bay Junction, an unforgiving mile-long bend.
QNS and L515 South, clear signal at West Ross Bay Junction.
The lead locomotive is 22 meters long, so the huge distance between its front and rear wheels can cause stress and excessive grinding on tight curves.
You're increasing your wear and tear on the wheels and on the track.
And if the turn is too severe, the loco's wheels could jump clean off the rail.
You're either dragging through it or you're plowing through it.
The cars are 12 meters shorter than the loco, so they move more easily through the turns. But to get round Ross Bay Junction, the immense locomotive needs something extraordinary. Beneath the 200-ton Goliath are two six-wheel steering assemblies. The front and rear wheels on each assembly are suspended by four steel springs and mounted on a single pivot. So when they hit a bend in the track, they turn freely. A steel crossbar connects to the rear axle. So when the front wheels turn, the rear wheels turn too, in the opposite direction, following the track. This innovative system means the huge loco can cruise round severe turns without losing speed or plowing off the track. The incredible self-steering system enables the locomotive to thunder through the curve of Ross Bay Junction. But with a train of this size and weight, no amount of breakthrough engineering can completely eliminate wear and tear.
Anytime you have a curve, your wear, track wear, wheel wear, flange wear, it's all elevated.
30 miles ahead of the freight train, rail workers have reported a fault with the track, a potential disaster. It falls to roadmaster Stefan Cormier to inspect the track and make sure the train can pass safely. He uses a specialized vehicle, the high rail, to race to the scene. Up top, it's a regular off-road truck. But this car wasn't just made to burn rubber. With the push of a button, it transforms to run on rails. Stefan must get out there quickly.
Another guy's on the track report to me a problem. He said to me he's supposed to have a broken bolt on a joint. We go to see.
Missing bolts could mean the track is loose. This could be extremely dangerous for the train and its $2.5 million payload. To reach the suspect rail, Stefan must get onto the main line, the same track the train runs on. It's a precarious situation. In 2014, a Louisiana couple caught on camera the destructive force of a freight train as it plowed into a crane truck.
Holy mother of Moo Moo.
The 10-ton truck had got stuck on the rail crossing. Luckily, its driver escaped before the collision and no one was hurt. But the truck was completely destroyed. Stefan's high rail vehicle is only a fraction of the size of the crane truck and 10,000 times lighter than the mega freight train.
We're 30,000 tons, give or take a couple pounds, but we're 30,000 tons. If I get a high rail in front of me and I hit him, I'm not even going to feel him.
In order to get onto the main line, high rail operators like Stefan put their lives in the hands of the dispatch operator. Today, it's Gilles Vaillancourt. He has control over who goes where and when.
Everybody must call the dispatch before to go on the track.
Like working on a constantly changing puzzle, Gilles has to coordinate the safe movement of multiple vehicles.
Sometimes we have 200 on the track.
Gilles gives Stefan authorization. He must get out to the damaged track. If Stefan doesn't move quickly, Gilles will have to stop the train. Not only does that increase wear, but it burns extra fuel when starting again.
It can cost maybe $1,000 or more to start a train like this on a hill. So we try not to stop it for nothing.
5 miles up the line, Stefan finds the loose bolt.
The train can pass, but we need to make a restriction speed, and my guys are coming to repair this problem.
Luckily, the other bolts are sound, and the rail is secure. But the mega train will have to slow to 10 miles an hour. Stefan calls in the speed restriction, and Gilles signals the train.
We just passed a yellow signal because they're doing maintenance on the main line.
Stefan keeps the train moving and gets himself out of harm's way. The train eases over the track with the missing bolt. And dispatch can issue a green light.
So with that, I'm allowed to go track speed.
Track speed here is nearly 40 miles an hour. Impressive considering the train is pulling the equivalent of 40 fully loaded Airbus A380s in iron ore.